So yes, guys, a couple days ago, I was checking my Gmail per use, and I received a message from my rival slash friend. I believe the term is frenemy, Vacation Tennis. I squared off with him recently. If you want to see that epic battle, upper right-hand corner right now. But he was informing me of a tournament at his local club, clay court tournament. But worth every penny, totally affordable. Couldn't help myself, signed up, and informed my trashman brother, Longshanks, who also jumped on board. So this vlog is going to detail our journey throughout this clay court endeavor.
What's up, guys? I'm in North Carolina right now and for a wedding, and Caleb emailed me like 2 days ago and was like, yo, you got a match Monday for a tournament that I signed up for and completely forgot about. So leaving North Carolina, 5 hour drive, first 3.5 singles tournament. There's 16 people in the field. I'm guaranteed 3 matches. Hopefully Caleb can be there to watch. Not sure what's going to happen, but since I'm in the 3-5 division, I'm feeling pretty good about it. I have grand aspirations. Hopefully I can, you know, make a deep run, but we'll see.
Hey!
Insisted that they not use my legal name, but my stage name, man. Taking the wings out from under me. The California Condor. Everybody knows. Who the heck is this Caleb schmuck? Anyways.
Just paid my dues. Heading to the courts now. Beautiful place. Honestly, I'm feeling really nervous. I've got like the jitters. This is a lot more than a normal UTR match. So glad I got here early to warm up and get the yips out. And this is... looks like where we're gonna be doing battle. Two beautiful clay courts.
The courts are beckoning, and I got a fan base over there just outside the gate. Better feed off of their energy. For those of you who don't know, I'm playing in the 4-0 bucket, so we'll see if I get chewed up and spat out or if I can show some sort of resilience and spread my wings and fly in California Condor fashion. All right, enough chit chat. Let's get warmed up.
Started off the match full of nerves and opted to serve because one of my mottos is it's better to do a thing than to live in fear of it. And I was really afraid to serve. I didn't think this guy could beat me, but I've been really deceived before judging someone on their warm up based on their strokes or their age or whatever, what have you. And that just doesn't matter in tennis. And I actually found myself facing 2 break points early, but I had some gumption in me and I was able to get out of that game, which built a lot of confidence. And one of the things that my opponent did well was come to the net. He got a lot of easy free points coming to the net. And even though he took that one, I did break him right off the bat. And then I held again, which was a huge bit of confidence. And in his second service game, I actually found myself facing 2 break points, and I'm ashamed to admit the tournament director was on the side, and I was thinking more about him watching than playing, and my opponent got out of the game and won that, so took it to 3-1. And then from there, it was actually a massive grind. We were trading breaks, trading holds. And I was actually serving for the match at 5-3, and I wasn't able to do it. I couldn't close it out. After I got broken, he held, and then he broke me again. So he had a 6-5 lead, and I was feeling a massive amount of pressure there, but I was able to break him. And in the tiebreak, I started thinking, you know what, if I can get out of this, I'm turning off the camera, because I need to focus on the match and not changing things. I was pretty happy with this point here. Look at this slide. And my opponent's exclamation afterwards made it doubly satisfying. My opponent also served pretty well. It took him a while to get his serve warmed up, but when he did, he was serving it out wide pretty consistently on the deuce side, and he was pretty good at going down the tee on the ad side. Played some pretty good defense on that point there. He was so good when he got to the net. This was like a lockstep play for him. He got so many free points off of it. I'm surprised he didn't do it more because 7 times out of 10, when he did it, he was coming away with the point.
Second.
This is me serving for the match. I didn't have a ton of great points from this. Not with the points that he won. I think they were just like pretty crappy, not worth showing you. And I ended up winning this point, and the only reason I'm including it is because of that cheeky little thing, which was really the only thing I could do. It was either that or go for the pooper scooper, which is a little unreliable. And then in his next service game, he held pretty easily. He was blasting serves. I could just feel the confidence oozing off of him. And then when I had to serve again at 5-5, I was like starting to panic. And his volleys, like him coming to the net, was just automatic for him. And he got out. He broke me so easily this game. And this was a break point right here. What a shot. I had no chance of getting to that. But when he was serving, I remember thinking, he's going to have the same nerves I have, and I just need to buckle down and do some grinding and get to work and make sure that I don't beat myself. I have to make him beat me. And fortunately on this, yeah, that was one of my best shots in the match. That deep backhand, felt really great about that. Got out of the service game alive. In the breaker, not a lot of quality. Both of us had a ton of double faults. This was early on, I believe. This might have been at 2-1. I got a mini break early, which really set the tone and gave me a lot of momentum in the set. Huge miss hit there, but luckily it was in. And let it out there, and I ended up taking it 7-4.
I'm holding a can of balls. If you're a true tennis head, you'll know that to the victor goes the spoils. Took the first round matchup, baby. Unbelievably relieved. I'm so thrilled that I was able to get that win. Score the match, 7-6, me, 6-4. In both sets, I had the chance to serve it out at 5-3, and in both sets, I couldn't do it. So I'm gonna have to fix that for next round, but absolutely pumped to be through to Thursday's matchup at 5:30. So let's go.
Just got to Caleb's round one matchup. Gonna be sitting in the player box like Banasi Kokkinakis. And he told me that if things don't go well for him, he's going to start abusing me, his wife, and his firstborn son. So hopefully this guy plays well today.
Yeah, well, let me clear the air and refute Ben's statement there. I would never consider abusing my wife nor my newborn. I can't say the same for Longshanks, though. Actually, I take great pleasure in abusing him. Tennistically speaking, it's one of my great pastimes, putting a licking on the kid on the tennis court. But enough about that. Let's get into these highlights. Second point of the match here, this opening game, I opted to return in the same form that Ben did. I was a little bit trepidatious about serving myself. I feared the inevitable would happen, that I would double fault and lay an egg. But yeah, look at these flatties. Plenty of pace, nice pop from the kid. Goes to show what type of opponent I was facing. Yep, overhead tucked away as he takes his opening game and holds to go up one zip, but oh wait, he's serving again. Yes, that's correct, folks. I skipped my opening service game in its entirety because, to be frank, there were no highlights. And what I feared came to be true. I double faulted and donated the first service game of mine and break to my opponent. So I'm down 2-love at this point, being run ragged across the baseline, but hanging in there actually. Doing pretty well to stay in it. And a couple backhands there. Nice little depth here, nice little rallies. And starting as I go on the offense there, I dump it into the net. So would go down love 3 at this point. And if I don't finally get on the scoreboard and hold down a double break, if I don't do my due diligence and win a game here, then yeah, pretty much the hinges would be blown off the dam and I'd be completely inundated. And now we'd be talking about embarrassment in front of my own family. Could not let that happen. And thank goodness, started to, again, hang with him in the rallies. Nice little ace there down the tee. Don't be mistaken, the double faults were running ragged, that's for sure. But that's the power of editing. Winky face. Couple backhands there, and with those, finally able to get my nose on the scoreboard. So 3-1 at this point. And, oof, nice, ferocious forehand. good placement too, and I come in appropriately, I would say, but I hesitated just slightly on the approach, and he who hesitates is lost in the same manner that that point was. 1-4 at this point during the changeover, speaking in riddles, cryptic messaging to my box.
Starting to find my feet.
Yeah.
I found them, and they're inept.
And then I realized, well, I'm not in the ATP, and there's no need to go to the bathroom to text for coaching. And by the way, if you had an issue with that dad joke, it was atrocious, I will admit. But I'll have you know, I recently became a father, got a newborn a couple weeks ago. And with that new status comes the right to pull dad jokes at my leisure. So you've been warned. They're going to come in tidal waves in my upcoming videos as I continue to commentate. But check this out. Winner, winner, chicken dinner. Nice forehand there. Inside in. For a nice change of pace. Don't see those too often. And again, here I am serving 1-4, trying to stay within quote unquote touching distance, just one break between us. Overhead, he gets it back, making me hit those extra balls, and golly, he steals it. Cat-like thief right from under my nose. And with it, the double break. So 5-1 at this point, he's looking to serve it out. I'm a breath away from swallowing a breadstick. And not from Olive Garden, mind you. But it's kind of, again, proven to... Certainly an underdog. Oh, my goodness. Kiss of an angel. Even my opponent, with all his quickness, wasn't able to get to that one. That goes to show how good and delicate that touch was. Break point here, as Ben said. He pulls me out wide. Forehand slice to stay in it. Running children. And a winner, just too good, as the notes say there. But I would hang in there, and like John Cena, he couldn't see me. I'd sneak the break a couple points later. And it would be 2-5. Oh, spank you very much. Jumping forehand winner. And the confidence would start to emanate off me. And with this potential comeback. Oh, man, he's quick. Can I just take a minute to acknowledge how good of a mover he is? But I hang in there with the forehand slice again and come through on that point. But with the comeback now in full swing, roaring back like the 20s, is an equal and or greater collapse. It was not on my own merit that this happened. He definitely gave me a couple games on double faults. I thought he was looking in the mirror and it was me. But nice rally there, deep balls. Ball was in need of an ice pack, it seemed, on that point. And 30 all, 6-5. Comeback complete. Set point on the rack. 40-30, folks. The Condor soaring to a momentous comeback. Oh, man. Okay. Well, I hit the net table on that one. But that's not going to stop me from really going for it. Don't stop now. You've come this far. Okay, well, that one was a fault. Let's see if this one goes through. And no, it's like I'm trying to watch it back and hoping for a different outcome. But no matter how many times you watch the footage, even from Ben's iPhone, the result is the same. I would double fault and blow my chance at winning the set.
Gut wrenching. Just lost in a breaker. Set point on my rack, bro. It was on my Dunlop stencil. And I didn't even get it in play, the double fault. My middle name. Might as well change it legally, bro.
Yeah, it was a pretty big choke chop.
The encouraging part is, I hung with them from the baseline. The most discouraging part and heartbreaking part and concerning part and perhaps I should quit tennis part, I didn't have to serve. Like, I couldn't will myself to serve it in the box. There's nothing I could do. I was possessed, an out of body experience for the worse. 6-7, love 6. Couldn't get any farther on the extremes of the spectrum. Don't litter, kids. But in this case, if you get bagels, I'll make an exception.